When I was young, I grew up studying the games of Anatoly Karpov. And some of the end games in which Karpov was very slightly better or even equal, he would grind out his opponents without you even getting to know how he did it. And that same feeling I got yesterday when I saw the game between Pragnananda and Michael Kresenkov. Pragnananda, only 15 years old, facing Michael Kresenkov, who is a 57-year-old, very experienced grandmaster from Poland, very strong player who has had an Elo of close to 2700 in the past. That's little Pragu there, who is very, very focused for his game. So let's get to the game, and I'll show you some of the key moments which really impressed me. So Pragnananda is playing with the white pieces and opens the game with one e4. Now Kresenko went e5, knight f3, knight f6. So it's the Petrov. Knight takes e5, d6, knight to f3, knight e4. And now Pragman played a slightly unusual move. He played bishop d3. So the main moves are d4. There's also queen e2. There's also d3 followed by d4. But he played bishop d3. Okay, Kresenko said, I'm going back. Castles. Bishop to e7 was played here. Rook e1, short castles. And bishop f1. I believe what Prague wanted was a fresh position. Here, white has no real advantage. He plays rook e8, d4. And also possible was to get equal share of space in the center with d5. But Kresenko played c6. Prague went c4. And now knight bd7, knight to c3, knight f8, and Prague went h3. Maybe at some point he wants to stop ideas of bishop g4. Now d5 was played, and the first interesting moment of the game, in order to try and fight for an advantage, you have to play queen b3, and that is exactly what Prague did here. He played his queen to b3. Well, it was possible to play the move c5, and I think it was a good move. But after bishop f5, it looks like black is doing fine. So queen b3. And now Kresenko played queen b6. Here I was a bit surprised by Prague's decision. He played here c takes d5. Maybe what he could have done is taken the queen ab, cd5, knight d5, knight d5, and cd5. And we would have reached this position. And let's say after a move like bishop b5, I think Pragnananda is definitely slightly better here, owing to a superior pawn structure. He went c takes d5 here directly in this position. And then after queen b3, ab3, knight d5, knight d5, cd5, turns out that the position is roundabout equal. So Prague went here for an interesting move, bishop b5, bishop d7, takes, takes. And now to attack this pawn here, he went rook to a5. So knight b6 can be played, but then bishop f4. Okay, white has some pressure. There is pressure here. You can also put pressure down the a file like this. So knight f6 was played here, and now Prague went bishop g5. Now Kresenko, with all his experience, realized that actually in this position it's not so important to fight for the d5 pawn, because even if that falls later on, he can get counterplay down the c file. But it's very important to protect the a7 pawn. So for example, if you play h6, then I can take, 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 and take on a7. That's the reason why he played the move king f8. I like this move. Rook to b5 was played in this position here. Okay, also, if you take, 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 king takes, and take here, black has a very strong move. I would like you to find it. What should black play here? Yes, rook to c8. This is a strong move here. And black is coming in, and he is at least equal. So, rook b5, interesting move. You will see now Pragnananda slowly weaving his magic. First, b6 was played. Now he brought his other rook. So there's some pressure on these pawns. The rook is kind of tied down. H6 by Kresenko. Takes, takes. And here, I did not understand Pragnananda's next move. Actually, I tried to think for some time. I mean, I do understand that rook takes d5 is not great because of rook e2. So Prague here went for the move rook a4. I would really like to ask him why he played this move. Maybe it was just to keep the rooks here for the time being, so that if rook e2 is played, then rook takes b6 is hanging. You know, both your rooks are on a and b5. But I think Krasenkov could have played rook d8 and defended this pawn, then tried to bring his king here. Would be round about even. He went rook c8. And from this moment onwards, I would like you to take note of Pragnadatta's play. This is where the Karpov-like feel sets in. First, he played the move g4. You know, it's a move that is ambitious. At the same time, you just feel, okay, he's improving his position. Maybe not much. He's not trying to do much. But somewhere there are certain aggressive intentions. He goes g4. Okay, king e7. Now he takes the pawn. Krasenko comes in. b2 cannot be defended. Okay, you can try to play rook a2 here, but it's too passive. Somehow, you can't be, you know, tying down your rook for this pawn. So Prague went h4. Now he wants to trap the bishop with g5. Although it's not actually getting trapped, let's say after rook b2, g5, take, take. There is king e6, which is an intermediate move. And black is doing okay here after rook b5, bishop d8, protecting this pawn. It should be equal. But Krasenko said, okay, let me keep my bishop on this diagonal. And he played the move g6, rook to b5, threatening rook b6, takes, g5, pawn takes, bgc7. Here, Pragnananda, of course, overcame the temptation of winning this pawn, because after AB, rook B, rook A8, rook B3, it's equal. So he went for the move king to G2 here. Just improving the position. Who knows? Maybe there'll be some pressure. Now, here, I think Krasenko made a good move. He played F6. He's like, okay, this pawn is cramping me. Let me play F6. Here, I mean, Pragnananda started to weave his magic with d5. So the right move now is f takes g5. And perhaps Krasenko did not like something here in this position. Maybe it could be this check. When after king d7, not much is happening, like knight g5, there is rook f8, pressure down f2 point. You see the rooks. This is a soft square for white. Also, you can go. Maybe knight takes g5, but then there's bishop f6, knight e4, bishop e5. It's around equal. He thought maybe let's improve the king, king d6. And now Prague went rook c4. So Pragnananda wants to go rook c6 check. Rook went to f8. This is a bad move. But to take advantage of it, you have to play very accurately. First a check. King went back. And now I want you to take some time and figure out what would you do next. So, okay, taking here is not really a threat. G6 is hanging. You don't want to take on F6. He will just take back. This rook is not very active, and Prague found the move rook B4. Very nice move, actually. Very classy move. FG5 was taken. Once again, I want you to pause and think what to do here as white. It's these little moves which are very difficult in chess, yeah, and Pragnananda was finding them one after the other. Okay, if you play rook takes g6, which might be the move you have thought of, then there is bishop c3, rook a4, and then a5. And with the very cute point that rook takes b6 here can be met with bishop b4. Just trapping this rook. I mean, it's out of the game and this position is equal. So Prague very clearly found that even taking on g5 is wrong because your f2 square is weak. So he found the move rook a4, which is really great. Now a7 is hanging, and then the king would get checkmated. You know, if you go rook a7, it's in big danger. So he played the move a5 here. Say if you take rook takes b3, then rook a7, king d8. Knight g5, already big trouble coming up here. Yeah. So he went a5. And now Prague took the pawn on b6. Again, not getting tempted for this same, yeah, bishop b4 thing. First, he took on b6. And here, Krasenko felt that he should play the move bishop c3. It's a natural move. And the idea is to protect this pawn and also go bishop b4. But it was important to understand that a5 pawn is not hanging actually. So what happens is if you go bishop h8, which is actually the best move in this position, you know, you go bishop h8. It's difficult to find this move on the board. And then after takes, I want you to find the best move for black, black to play. Rook takes f2. Kudos if you found this. It means you are very alert. King takes and bishop d4 check. The knight is pinned here and the rook is lost. So that's the reason why. Also, bishop f6 was a better fighting move. Bishop c3. Now, Prag did not fall for the temptation of winning this pawn. He saw that his rook will get trapped with bishop b4. So he went rook c4. Very nice move. And here, Krasenkov really understood the dangers in his position. For example, if you now go bishop b4, there is knight e5 check. The knight now joins in and it's a mate. You know, you're just going to lose material. King here, take, finish. So, not bishop b4. If you go back bishop h8 now, then I can go rook c6. g4, check. King here, check, king e7, check, king here, check, king here, check, and over. Or maybe take with the other rook, yeah, this better. And then, just mate. So, after seeing these lines, you are like, okay, I have to, and g4 is the best move, so that if you take here, then I can take on f3. So, he went rook g4, good move. Now, g6 is hanging, so g5 was played. You can't take with the knight because of this problem. Here, you can't take with the rook because, again, this problem that we have seen. So, he went again, Prag went rook c4. He found the best two. G4. So like, Krasenko has the same problem, even though he gave one pawn. Prag took another pawn. The idea is that eventually, now if the rook goes to c4, there are ideas of rook g8 check creating play. But this time, Prag went not from this side to see, like, to join his rooks. He went from this side to keep his rooks joined. Such little minute understanding, yeah. Bishop a1, check, king c8, rook b5, attacking a5, bishop f6, and now knight d2 was played. When Krasenkov resigned because the rook is hanging, let's say you defend it, my knight joins in, check coming here, piece hanging. It was all over. And Pragnananda won the game with some tremendous play. Don't you think this was amazing? I like to call Pragnananda Prago after this game, after Pragnananda plus Karpov. Tremendous game, and I really enjoyed it. Also, like Magnus Carlsen, yeah, like Carlsen also grinds out such wins. Speaks volumes about this young boy's talent. He now has to hold himself with the black pieces, hold the match. He will advance to the fourth round of the World Cup if he does that. Does that looks very, very likely where he will face MVL. Best wishes to Prag. This is Sagar Shah signing off. Bye-bye.